YouTube videos with...
Oh, you had me at YouTube videos. Let's go, Boaty.
Hello, my lovelies. And you join me as I'm heading off to work. A little bit late for reasons that I will tell you. And I am in my MG. But no, not that one. Not the new one. Not Fraulein Wetleg von Titty Biscuits. No, I'm in the big boy. I'm in Stigbürt, the ZT190. Couple of reasons for that. One is that, in theory, Wetleg isn't taxed because the change of ownership has been done. And it's the 31st of the month, and obviously I'm not going to tax it today to pay a month to tax it for one day. So she can stay rested up, have a rest from her efforts of yesterday, and I will tax her at midnight and she can go to work tomorrow. The other reason is I've been battling with a low battery on Stigbürt because, quite honestly, I've just not used him enough over winter. Not used him regularly enough. He's a big old boy and the battery takes a bit of charging. So it's finally made its way into my thick head that sod the fuel expense. I need to take him to work once a week, keep everything turning over, keep the battery charged. So this is going to be a weekly thing. In fact, they all need to do one day a week on the work trip. Get them earning their corn. Anyway, should I need an excuse to take Stigbürt out for a thrash? This is a fabulous car to drive. Very, very different to the little MG that I drove back from Southampton last night. Although that has had a sting in the tail. I've been editing the video today. I've been editing that video for hours. And I was determined to get it uploaded before I went to work. And it didn't quite work out like that. I took a lot of footage yesterday. And all of that footage has clogged up my iPad. So I've desperately had to try and free up storage room to transfer the completed movie. And it's a little bit longer than usual. It just took forever to upload and it still hasn't. I uploaded it, it did the preparation. It did the upload, and then it has to process from SD to HD. And it just hung on 99% for about 17 minutes. And I'm desperately waiting for it to just tick over. That's why I'm late going to work. I'm hoping I can make up the time by being in a big thrusty V6 and getting my right hoof down, which will do wonders for the battery charging as well. It'll do Stigbürt the world a good to have a night out. Uh, And I've dragged my iPad with me, and I'm desperately hoping that work is going to be absolutely dead, so I can just sit down for 20 minutes and finish the video off, do the make sure the processing is done, and quickly do a thumbnail and description and whatnot. And hopefully, by the time you're watching this, I did get it out last night at 19:19. But we shall see. This is rather nice. Bit of light left in the sky, isn't there? And okay, here's a question. Can you see it? What's that star up there? Considerably darker in this direction. Feels good to actually be driving Stigbürt with a purpose. I must do much more with this car this year. Much more than just terms of use and enjoyment. One little sign of things to come. The roof lining is becoming unstuck. It's inevitable, isn't it? It'll happen on all of them. Well, all of them apart from wet leg. One of the few MG Rovers not to suffer with the roof lining. Ah, I wonder if any of you clever people out there can help me. The EML light is back on in Stigbürt. Now, I bought an OBD reader. It's just a generic OBD2. And it works with most of the cars, but... oh, what on earth was that? Is that an owl? But it won't read Stigbürt. Can any of you lot point me in the direction of a relatively basic OBD that will read Stigbürt? I mean, as I understand it, in theory, he's a 2003 ZT190. Now, as I understand it, in theory, should be OBD2 compatible. But it's not happening, and I know my reader works because it works on the other cars. So I just need a basic one that will read the codes and clear the codes. So if anybody can help, I'd be most awfully grateful. Both I and Stigbürt are warming up nicely. I dread to think what this will be actually costing me. If you weren't aware, the ZT190 is not noted for its frugality. Not by a long chalk. So this is the last day of January then. How has it been for you? Seems to have flown by for me, which is kind of nice. Kind of feels like we're galloping towards spring. Oh, it's turned off. That's nice. Oh, I put my hoof down a bit. And of course, February is the shortest month, so before you know it, it will be one of the most important days of the year, St. David's Day. Just had a YouTube thing flash up. I'm hoping to God it's the notification that the bloody video has processed and there are no copyright infringements. Ooh. Hopefully this will do wonders for Stigbürt's battery. I will put the tester on tomorrow, see what the battery's doing, make sure that it has survived okay, because it's been well down a couple of times. That's entirely my fault, not keeping on top of the situation. It's just that winter thing of it being too cold to go and ask about outside. I mean, what I should have done is what I nag Mustard for not doing, and that's just lifting the terminal. Well, I shouldn't really need to, because all of my cars are in theory taxed, roadworthy, up and running, so I should just be using them. And that is what I pledge to do. They will all go to work once a week. Actually, how many cars have I got now? 6. So that means that every day I should be using a different car. That's fun. Quite a neat little equation, really, isn't it? I had planned to do a little bit more in-depth filming with Wet Leg today, but the day has just disappeared. I was up at a very reasonable time, considering the day I had yesterday, and I didn't just lounge around or laze around. I cracked on with things. I cracked on with getting all of the clips downloaded and starting to edit yesterday's video together. I wanted to crack on because the plan was to do both, to get the video edited and uploaded and get some footage for tomorrow's video. But yeah, best laid plans and all that. So I've put a solid 7 hours in today. God, I have actually. Although a lot of that time was just waiting for stuff to actually download from the cloud onto the iPad, so I could start the editing. So I thought I'd salvage a day by filming this a little bit, get some footage for tomorrow. Welcome to Wessington. Right, we shall salute the Honourable Bridge, and then I shall put you on fast forward for the last little bit. Nothing for you to see, really. Too dark, isn't it? But I obviously wouldn't let you miss the Honourable Bridge. That just wouldn't be cricket. Would it, Roger Boaty? Together now, after 3, 1, 2, 3, greetings, Honourable Bridge. I went over that yesterday, didn't I? I didn't see it though. The the old London train was a bit on the full side. I had a reserved seat, so that was fine, and there was nobody next to me. There was the other side of the table, but I had a table seat with a PowerPoint, so it was all good. Right, fast forward for you. Lovely little coincidence this evening. I'd popped to Sainsbury's to get some bits and pieces, and as I was heading into the car park, there was a custard missile, a little yellow streetwise parking up, and I thought, well, I have to observe the laws. So I parked next door but one. And when they got out of the car, I got out and said, nice car. And we got chatting, and it turns out that the two lovely ladies are part of some sort of clan who own the mystery fleet of Rovers that and MGs that Matt underscore has been spotting in his neck of the woods. And they've got some amazing cars by the sound of it. And they've got exactly the same ethos as many of us. They're not about perfection necessarily, but they are about saving as many of these cars as possible and keeping them roadworthy, MOT, legal and enjoyed. And the fabulous news is that not only have they subbed to the channel, but they've joined the Facebook community as well. So do nip into Facebook and say hi to them, make them welcome. Gosh, it is super windy today and tonight. All these leaves still knocking around. Oh well, everything will soon be turning green. It's February tomorrow, isn't it? Right, I'm going to listen to a song, and that means I have to turn you off, because copyright. But let's play a game of Name That Tune. I'll let you hear the first few notes, and pop in the comments what you think the song is. If you recognize it. Super short video tonight, my lovelies. As I said, I seem to lose all of today editing the epic collection calamity. But there's always the live stream, isn't there? And hopefully, especially if the wind dies down a bit, we'll get some wet leg footage tomorrow. Although the lovely Phil who sold me the MGF isn't terribly keen on the name, I think it's fair to say. He probably hasn't seen the names of the others. I think Fräulein Wet Leg von Titty Biscuits fits in very well with her older brother here, the Honourable Stigbürt von Thundercock. And now, we've got the fun bit coming up to finish the evening off. I've really enjoyed driving Stigbürt. He's different, just as Wetleg is different, but Stigbürt is different in a different way, a kind of meaty, beaty, big and bouncy way. Here comes the speed restriction. Ha-ha! And here comes the gear change. A bit careful in Stigbürt. You get used to the other ones, a little 1.4 and 1.6, and you know, not a problem to take those to the red line. Do the same thing in Stigbürt, and you know, before you know it, you're travelling at a speed that is somewhat less than legal and quite possibly unwise. Which of course makes it fun. Oh bums, I've just remembered I'm gonna have to park this a million miles away, right down at the bottom of the road. First world problems, eh? And then walk up the hill into a headwind. I've turned into a right lazy old sod. She is, bless her. Oh. Well, that wasn't supposed to happen. Oh dear. Oh well, saves me taking it off, doesn't it? And I guess on that note, I might as well say thank you for watching. Good night, and I'll catch you next time. Good night, my lovelies.